loose our hands, hallelujah, that he had gave us on this month, on tonight, hallelujah. Can we use our feet that he gave us on tonight, hallelujah. Can we can we use our mouth that he gave us, hallelujah, hallelujah. Can we use our breath on today that he gave us, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father God, we thank you on tonight, hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, for all the gifts that you gave us on tonight, Father. Father God, we thank you in the name of Jesus, Father God, for, Father God, that the feet that you gave us, Lord. Father, we thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Father. Father, for the hands that you gave us on tonight, Father. Father, we thank you, oh God, in the name of Jesus, that you are God and God alone, Father. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, hallelujah, that, Father God, that we have breath in our body on tonight. In the name of Jesus, everything that has breath, but now, hallelujah, open up your mouth and give me praise, hallelujah. How you say, in all your ways, acknowledge me, hallelujah, and I shall direct your path. Hallelujah, and I just thank you, oh, Lord, on tonight, hallelujah, Father God, that you are, hallelujah, my path, Lord. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, O God, for leading me to knowledge and understanding on tonight. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, O Lord, that there is healing on tonight. Hallelujah, I thank you, O God, in the name of Jesus, that, Father God, that you are healed, the miracle worker, on a Wednesday night. Hallelujah, I thank you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, O God, hallelujah, that you can make a way out of no way. When there is no way, hallelujah, you can make a way, Father, in the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Father God, I thank you all tonight in the name of Jesus. Oh God, you matter, God. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, oh Lord, for you've been Jehovah Jireh, which is my provider. Hallelujah, I thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, for you've been a peace, the Prince of Peace. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, hallelujah. Oh God, for word in my pastor's mouth, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, I thank you, oh God, for sending him a word down from heaven, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, O Lord, for hiding him behind the cross, God, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus, that, hallelujah, that a word is in his belly, O God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, I thank you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. I have wanted for nothing, hallelujah, for you are God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, you are our Father, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, that our thoughts is on you, oh, God. In the name of Jesus, our mind is on you on tonight. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, oh, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that, Father God, your word, Father God, is hidden in our heart, Father, in the name of Jesus. I think that we won't be the same way that we came, oh, God. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. I thank you, oh, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, that, Father God, everything through you, Father, how it is possible, Father. Hallelujah. There is nothing too hard for you tonight. In the name of Jesus, there is nothing too hard for you, Father. In the name of Jesus, we shall rejoice. We shall rejoice and be glad in it, Father. In the name of Jesus, we can open up our mouth, hallelujah, and give you a shout out of our mouth, Father. Oh God, we can open up our mouth, oh God. Hallelujah, because Father, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, you loved us so much that you willing to die for us. You laid down your life for us, Father. In the name of Jesus, oh God, woe to me, oh God, if I don't open up my mouth on tonight and give you praise, oh God. Woe to me, Father, hallelujah, if I don't jump for joy on tonight. Woe to me, God, hallelujah, if I don't do what you ask me to do on tonight. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, oh God, hallelujah, I came to lift you up on tonight. I came to open up my mouth on tonight. I came to praise you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, I thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, for your blood, God. Your blood that washed me, God. Your blood that cleansed me, Father. I thank you, oh Lord, for that blood, Father. Hallelujah. I thank you for paying it for me already, God. How you pay for me, God. Hallelujah. I refuse not to praise you. I refuse, hallelujah, not to dance for you, Lord. I refuse to be ashamed of you, Lord. Oh, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father. Hallelujah. I came to lift you up. I came to lift you up because you are a big God. Yes, you are. Oh, yes, you are, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I command the victory to move now in the name of Jesus. I command healing to move now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you praise. Oh, God, hallelujah. I thank you, oh, Lord, that we are a royal priesthood. I thank you, Father, that we are more than a conqueror. I thank you, Father, that Father God, in the name of Jesus, that we are your chosen generation. I thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus, oh God, that we are kingdom children. In the name of Jesus, we belong to you and you belong to us. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, that you are our Father, which is in heaven. I thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, oh God, that you are more than a brother. Hallelujah, oh God. I thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, that Father God, oh God, that you're going to move in this place right now in the name of Jesus. I thank you, oh Lord, for moving already, Father. I thank you, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, for bringing the fire already, Father. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, oh God, for bringing your peace now. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, oh God, for moving your love around, Father. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, oh Lord, for so loving the world that you gave your only begotten Son, that whoever believed in him should not perish, but to have everlasting life. Oh God, that is so beautiful, Father. That is so beautiful, Father. That you would give a backslider, oh God, in the name of Jesus, your love, Father. That, Father God, that you would change our mind, Father God, our filthy mind. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, and pit it with your mind, Father. Oh God, we thank you on tonight. We thank you on tonight in the name of Jesus. And we shall lift you up on tonight in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Come on, can we rejoice unto the Lord? Come on, can we make a joyful noise unto the Lord? Hallelujah. Come on, somebody open up your mouth and make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody magnify the Lord in here today. Magnify the Lord in here today. Come on, don't just shout for 5 seconds, but let your spirit cry out to him. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, let your spirit cry out to the Lord today. Hallelujah. Lord, you're worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you're worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Oh, God, you're so worthy to be praised, Lord. Oh, you're worthy, Lord. You're worthy, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on. How many know that the Lord has made some promises to us and to his people? Amen. And he ain't broken not one of them yet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on. Let's praise the Lord and just let you know that he has promised something to you. Amen. And it shall come to pass. Hallelujah. Want to come to pass, somebody? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just want to honor the Lord. Amen. And he's just marvelous. Oh, hallelujah. Say, oh, how wonderful.
Oh, how wonderful it is.
Say, Jesus promised.
Jesus promised he'll take care of me.
Oh, how wonderful it is.
How wonderful it is.
Jesus promised.
Jesus promised he'll take care of me.
Oh, how wonderful.
How wonderful it is.
Say, Jesus promised.
Jesus promised he'll take care of me.
Oh, can anybody tell me that he's marvelous?
Oh, how marvelous it is.
Oh, he's a marvelous God. And what?
Jesus promised he'll take care of me.
Oh, can we just say he is so wonderful?
Oh, how wonderful it is.
Oh, you're so wonderful. Because you promised.
Jesus promised he'll take care of me.
Oh, oh, how marvelous.
About the future.
all I gotta do. Yes, I can. Say what? Jesus is going to take care of you in every area of your life, the good and the bad. Somebody open up your mouth and rejoice. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on. Anybody know he kept his promise and that's why we're still here? Hallelujah. We're still here because he's keeping his promise. Hallelujah. Come on. Let's run it. Listen. still here. Bruises, I'm taking my lumps and bruises, but I'm still here. Yes, I am. Loneliness, I've had my share of loneliness, but I'm still here. Cause through it all,
another day's journey.
God kept me
here.
I relate to that this evening. I made it through
another day's journey.
God kept me here. I want to see if y'all can relate to this part. Many times I've been idle, but I'm still here. Thank you, Lord. Burdens I've had to bear, so many burdens, but I'm still here, standing here. Dark days, I've had my share of dark days, but I'm still here. Yes, I am. Disappointments, I've had so many disappointments, but I'm still here. See, through it all,
Another day's journey.
God kept me here. I want to say this thing. The grace of God that I'm still here today. Cause he was always there, no matter what. He's always a very present help in my time of need. And he right there, just a sweet
amount. I've made the day's journey. God kept me here.
It was only you, Jesus, that kept me. You kept me. That's why
I made it.
Another
day's journey.
You gave me one more.
God kept me here.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. I want to tell y'all something.
I made it. I'm still here.
Praising God because you've been through trials and trials, but you're still here. Hallelujah.
Come on, let's praise the Lord, everybody. Come on. Come on, we can do better than that. I said, praise the Lord, everybody. Hallelujah. Come on, you ought to open up your mouth and come on. Just because you're still here, can you give God praise because you're still here?
Oh, come on, come on. I said, can you open up your mouth that you made it through danger seen and unseen? Come on. You ought to open up your mouth and tell God, I'm still here. Come on. I said, you ought to open up your mouth and say, Father, I'm still here. And it's because of you, Father, that we're still here. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Come on. Put your hands together one more time for Jesus. I said, put your hands together for Jesus one more time. Hallelujah. Glory to our Father. Hallelujah. We welcome you tonight to Boot Camp Bible Study. I'm so pleased and honored to say that our visionary and leader is none other than Pastor Mustafa. Can you celebrate our pastor tonight? Come on. Oh, we can do better than that. I said, let's celebrate our leader tonight. Hallelujah. And we celebrate the fragrance of this house, our first lady. Lady Nell, we honor you tonight. Hallelujah. And come on, let's clap it up for yourself tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Let us read and recite our mission statement. Basic Ministries exists as the church of the 21st century to help, heal, empower, lead, and prosper God's people and their community in order to bring glory to our Father, which is in heaven. Amen. And why does Basic exist? Amen. Amen. Can we celebrate Reverend Wanda, who's here tonight? Can we celebrate her? We honor the Lord for you. We're excited to hear, amen, what God is going to say through her on tonight. Amen. Amen. For we know that God is a spirit, and where does he live? Do me a favor and go greet somebody, amen, with some love that you did not come to church with. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, let's put our hands together. It is time for our basic news. Let's put our hands together. Amen. Let's remember, amen, a scripture a day. It definitely keeps the devil away. This week, we are in Acts chapter 21 through Acts chapter 26. Amen. We are in Acts chapter 21 through Acts chapter 26. Acts is almost coming to an end, y'all. Job, we pray. We got a new book. Amen. Where are we going to, Lady Nim? Joshua, the book of Joshua. Amen. So we're excited. Amen. We're excited about Bible battle this week. Amen. Auntie, amen. Sister Alicia will be going against Sister Gina. Amen. So we're excited about that Bible battle next week. How many has been enjoying Pastor's new series? He is. Amen. We're excited. Amen. Amen. To hear about, amen, what God is going to say to him this Sunday. Amen. This has been a wonderful, wonderful series where we get to find out who God is to us. Amen. Brothers and sisters, please make sure that you're sharing, amen, the messages, amen, on your social media page so people can hear what the Lord has been saying to us. We want to make sure that you are praying with your prayer partners, brothers and sisters. Amen. How many has been praying with their prayer partner? Amen. Please make sure that you pray with your prayer partner at least once a week. Amen. For only 30 minutes. We only ask for 30 minutes, amen, of your time. Amen. Brothers and sisters, First Fruits with Pastor Moon every Monday through Friday, starting promptly at 7 a.m. Amen. Can we clap it up for Deacon Stallings? Come on, let's send some love to Deacon Stallings, who does a wonderful job
and the Feed My Sheep staff. They do a wonderful job. Amen. Amen for Feed My Sheep. So join us every Monday through Friday, starting promptly at 7 a.m. on Zoom. I'm happy to report that we have fed 1,239 families already here at Basic Ministry. Amen. Amen. We feed here every Wednesday, starting setting up promptly at 12 noon, and we start distributing groceries at 2 o'clock p.m. Amen. If you would like to be a part of this awesome ministry, you can see Minister Alex, who's standing right here. Amen. We will get you acclimated to this ministry. If you need groceries, please don't hesitate. We got you covered right here at Basic Ministry every Wednesday. Amen. I'm excited about our first, the Fruit of the Holy Spirit series. Amen. This has been an awesome series. We only have two fruits left. Amen. Reverend Wanda will be teaching, amen, tonight, but next week, well, not next week, but the week after that, we'll go back into our Fruit of the Spirit, Fruit of the Holy Spirit series. Amen. Brothers and sisters, please make sure that you have downloaded our church app and that you are in our, and that you're acclimated inside of our church app. If you're not, please make sure that you see Deacon James today so we can get you inside of our church database system. Amen. As we move into our spring and summer months, we will, brothers and sisters, be sending out a lot of communication via our church app, and we want to make sure that you don't get left behind. Amen. Amen. Baptism Sunday is this Sunday. Amen. We haven't had anyone signed up, but if we get somebody to sign up between now and Saturday, amen, morning, we will have Baptism Sunday. Amen. So please make sure, if you would like to go down in Jesus' name, amen, that you see myself and I'll get you on that list. Amen. My Bible in my boom box. Amen. We are excited about the All Red Party that is happening on April 1st right here at Basic Ministries. Let's see who's going to be here, y'all.
Lord, be a fence around my life. I cannot stop praying. Devil, take your hands off my mind. You is not my friend.
And make me just like you. Walk in, talk, and do what you do. Washed in your black tie, I'm a seeker.
Made many mistakes, yeah, go ahead and judge me. And even when I fall, man, I know he love me. And even when I call, man, I know he love me.
Queen on my level, boy, devil be an L.I.E. Gotta make sure you have a God for you, D.I.E. Everybody say on God. G-O-D, but they be capping all the time, straight up L-I-E.
I was blind, but God wrapped his arms right around my head. Grew up in the church, trying to clown, mama pop my leg.
Hey, man, we are officially a little bit over a week away from the dopest party in Jesus' name that you will ever experience. Amen. If you do not have tickets, brothers and sisters, we want to make sure, amen, that you purchase a ticket. You can do so tonight by seeing Lady Nail. We want to pack this place out. Brothers and sisters, if you are selling tickets, please do turn in all of your monies to Lady Nail this Sunday. Amen. This Sunday. Amen. Yes, sir, Pastor.
Amen. Just regarding the Bible and boombox, brothers and sisters, please, amen, promote. Amen. Like he said, we're almost 1 week away. Amen. And we want to make sure, amen, amen, like I said, that this place is packed out. Amen. I have been praying for this. Amen. We're believing God to do, amen, great things in the midst of his people. Amen. Set this generation on fire. Amen. Amen. So please, if you can, brothers and sisters, let your family know, let your friends know, let everybody know. Amen. April 1st. Amen. We're going to turn the word up. Is that all right, y'all? All right. Come on.
Amen. Come on, let's put our hands together for my Bible, my boombox. Amen. We're excited. Amen. Amen. We're excited about, amen, Good Friday. We are hitting the block and telling people about Jesus. Amen. Every Good Friday, we go take the gospel, amen, to the streets. So we are so excited that April 7th, we will be on 98th and Eads, amen, at 6 o'clock p.m. We will be at 3 o'clock p.m. Please forgive me. Amen. Hallelujah. Me and Pastor just had a meeting right now. Amen. 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 3 o'clock. Amen. I'm sorry. So 3 o'clock, I will make sure that we will make that correction. 12 o'clock. Amen. Amen. That's a lot of hours earlier. Amen. 12 o'clock, 12 noon, we will be on 98th and Eads telling people about Jesus, and we'll be doing our 7 last sayings to Christ. Amen. I'm excited about Resurrection Sunday. Woo! We are celebrating the resurrection of our Lord and Savior. Amen. Please make sure that you join us right here at Basic Ministry. Amen. At 11:30 for an amazing, amazing worship experience. Amen. Amen. Please make sure that you're sharing this. We're excited that Pastor is going on tour. Amen. We're excited. Amen. Let's see what cities that he's going to go to.
I'm familiar with defeat, not down, but fear did not keep me from getting up when I fall again. I just put the cycle on repeat.
Faith that been God till my life is over.
Ay. I done been everywhere that you trying to go. So take a seat, son, and enjoy the show. I dipped my hand in gold, then I rolled the dice. It came back in folds, now it's on the night.
We did a hit till they think what's out of me.
Let your word be in me just like an IV.
I didn't call like I stole your ID. Can't tell the difference if it's you or if it's me.
Visions in my mind, talk to a cycle. Back and forth to prison, I need to break this cycle. Incarcerated, agitated, felt I couldn't breathe. Gladiator school, where gangsters go to bleed.
Hey, have mercy on me, have mercy on my soul. Some say you gotta get it while the game's good. Diamond in the rough.
Come on, let's put our hands together for the Against the All Odds tour. We are excited. Pastor will be in Arizona on the 21st. Then we're going to LA on the 22nd. And guess what? The tour stops right here on the 23rd of April. Please make sure, brothers and sisters, that you have noted in your calendar that we will not be having service at our regular usual time at 11:30. Pastor would like us all to be here at 6 o'clock p.m. Amen. To pack this place out. Amen. So we are so excited about what the Lord is doing in the month of April. Brothers and sisters, we do have our own clothing line right here at Basic Ministry. Amen. And we're so excited, amen, about that. If you do not, amen, have these any of these sweatshirts or hoodies, please make sure that you see Lady Nail. We are so excited about our spring and summer collection that we are working on and we'll be launching soon. We do have our blood stained shirt, amen, that is coming out. Amen. I got my pants today for my Baba My Boomer. I don't know if that shirt gonna go with my fit, Chief, but I'm gonna wear it on Easter Sunday. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Brothers and sisters, please make sure, amen, amen, that you get this. We're asking, if you can, please wear this shirt to my Bible, my boombox, or wear it, amen, during Holy Week or on Resurrection Sunday. You can purchase it today by seeing Lady Nail. Amen. I'm excited about the Dare to Dream program that's returning this summer. Hallelujah. This is our mentorship and internship program. Amen. We take a group of young kids out of the city of Oakland and we put them through a 7-week course, amen, where we teach them about college, we teach them about business, and we teach them about Jesus. Amen. And at the end of this program, they get $1,000 stipend if they complete the program. Amen. We are looking for people to partner with us. You can do so today by scanning that QR code. Amen. Or you can go to our website. Amen. Be one of our fiscal sponsors. Amen. And you can go to our website at www.jointhethamovement.com. Amen. Amen. Let's put our hands together for all of our announcements. Amen. Lady Nail is coming at this time for Bible Drill.
Almost won. Okay, I think we got a lot of ladies in here tonight, so we can pull it off tonight, right, ladies? All right. For those who don't know how the Bible drill goes, you need a real Bible in your hand, a real Bible, a real sword. You put it up in the air, right? You're gonna yell out a scripture and the verse. You have to find it while you're still in your seat, and then yell amen, stand up, and read the scripture. You cannot be while you're standing in the air. All right. We are very competitive here at Basic Ministries. Lioness, make some noise. And roll call. All right. Catch me, y'all. Get your Bibles up. Hey, 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 hey. I need my ladies. All right. listening to. There is always a theme, so pay attention to the scripture. Leviticus 19:2. Amen. He is. That's the word. All right. Come on, ladies. Let's get your Bibles in here. Nika, girl. Come on. Get your Bibles up. Someone please find 1 Peter. 1 Peter 1:16. 1 Peter 1:16. Amen. I told you I need her. Amen. That's the word. One and one. Here we go. Get them up. Get them up. Get them up. Get them up. Let's see. Can somebody please find Isaiah 6:3. Isaiah 6:3.
You didn't stand up.
That's it. Yes. Come on, ladies. Come through. Here we go. Can we find Acts 2:4? Acts. Woo! Got him. We taking this one home. Let's do Mark 1:8. Mark 1:8. Mark. Mama Mary. Hey, what's tonight's theme, y'all? Holy. Give it up for the lioness.
Amen. Amen. Come on, brothers. We can give it up for our sisters. Amen. It's all right. One thing I learned about in sports, amen, you have to know how to win and know how to lose. Amen. Amen. You have to win with class, and even if you lose, you have to lose with class. Amen. Amen. We lost with class. Amen. We'll cry when we get in the car. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. Thank you, amen. Amen. It's good to see everybody in the building. Amen. We thank God for having Reverend Wanda with us tonight. Amen. 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 I thank God because, you know, this was a busy weekend. Amen, from last week, and amen, world changers, then game nights, and then Sunday in the block, and then we have to do a funeral service on Monday. Amen. God has definitely allowed us to be fruitful this weekend. Amen. But with all honesty, I was so glad to see Reverend Wanda walking that door. I said, Lord, I'm tired. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I thank God that there's more gifts to the body of Christ. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. So, of course, tonight, brothers and sisters, we're going to be dealing with, amen, mental health, our mind. Amen. One of the reasons we're dealing with this, and I think it is, and she'll, of course, come behind me, but I think it's so important that we deal with this because I don't ever see, I work in social services. I work with the Barrier Rescue Mission and our brothers in our community. Amen. And I don't think I've never seen more people that have lost their mind in my life. Right. This is starting to become an epidemic in our community. Amen. That our brothers and sisters, amen, are walking around, amen, confused, amen, in their head, amen, that the enemy's attacking their soul. Your mind is a part of your soul. Are y'all listening to me? Amen. Do you know the Bible tells us that it's with the mind we serve the Lord? Amen. The Bible tells us it's with the mind that we serve the Lord. Amen. We serve the Lord with our head. Amen. With our thoughts. Amen. That's why we have to cast every imagination that tries to exalt itself, amen, above the word of God and bring it to captivity. Amen. The Bible also tells us in the book of Timothy that God has not given us the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. The Lord wants you to have a sound mind, brothers and sisters. Amen. Amen. So we were just building you from the head down. Amen. One thought that came to my mind, I'm going to pass this mic, amen, and give it, amen, to our teacher tonight, amen. But I was talking to some brothers and sisters earlier today. I said, everything you do should stem from one thought. Everything you do should stem from one thought, amen. And that thought for us as believers is, I'm going to bless the Lord. I woke up this morning with one agenda, to bless the Lord. Now, how I do that may come in different ways. I may pray with people. We may feed people. We may preach to people. We may wave at people. But I have one agenda, one thought, bless the Lord. You have to bring your life to one thought. You cannot have all those thoughts in your head. Are y'all listening to me? That's making you not be of sound mind. You're double-minded. And a double-minded person is unstable in all the ways. You have to have one thought as a believer. I have been born to bless the Lord. Even in my trials, I'm going to get God glory out of this. Even facing the giant, I'm going to kill you. I'm going to give God glory. You have to have one. One is a number of hope. He's going to do the rest. You remember Pinky and the Brain? You don't know it. That's wow. How young are you? How do you know what Pinky and the Brain? Remember that? Pinky would ask the brain every cartoon. Same thing we try to do. Now you can policy take over the world. Now he might use different instruments. He might build different tools. Every episode was different on how he was trying to take over the world. I have one thought. I've been born to bless the Lord. Amen. I'm alive today to do what? Amen. I'm alive today to do what? That's it. And that's in every situation. Your main thought. Amen. And we're going to get ready to bring Reverend Wanda. We thank God for Jorge being. Amen. Always supporting of the Oscar Grant Foundation. Definitely admire this woman of God. Amen. At home. But our sister, she has turned her. Are y'all listening to me? That's the power of God. That's what God. Christ took it.
Are y'all listening to me? You have to know how to turn the worst thing that happened in your life and use it. I'm going to bless the Lord. You can do it. But with a broken heart, I'm still going to bless the Lord. Good God Almighty. Tears running down my face. I'm going to bless the Lord. And God will use your pain to take you all over the country, giving life. And that's what the Lord is doing with our sister. Amen. Reverend Wanda. Amen. She's all over the country giving life. Amen. To people fighting for mothers and children in our community. Amen. So we thank God for her being in our midst tonight. Amen. She's handed out some papers. Amen. We need everybody to fill those out. Amen. And at the end, please turn them in to Brother Kevin. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Let's give God a round of applause. Amen. For his gift to the body. Amen. Reverend Wanda Johnson of the Oscar Grant Foundation. Amen.
Let us look to the Lord in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father God, we thank you. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You are the God who knows all things. And you created mankind. You created us, God, to praise you. And so, God, we praise you and we thank you, God, for who you are. God, we thank you for your loving kindness and your tender mercy. God, we thank you for your spirit being in this place. God, we ask that you would speak to us on this evening, oh God. And God, even as we leave this place tonight, God, let us never be the same again. God, let your spirit, oh God, manifest itself in us on tonight. We die to self. And we ask that the spirit would rise in us, oh God. God, we thank you for your Holy Spirit that is our teacher, that is our instructor, that is our helper, that is our rebuker. God, we thank you on tonight. And God, as we prepare to hear from you, oh God, and the lesson, teach us on tonight, oh God. And God, for that, we give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God. Praise God. I thank Pastor Mustafa for the opportunity to even come before you on today. And I want to say first, you know, we sometimes take for granted the little organs that we have. You know, we take for granted the smelling and we take for granted the smelling and different things. And I never knew how hard it was to operate with only one side of your face working. I never knew how hard it was to experience where you want to smell, but the smell is not a full smell because of the Bell's palsy or the paralysis in the side of the face. But and I'm saying that to say that in everything the scripture says, give thanks unto the Lord. In everything. So even the little insignificant things that we think about, we still need to give thanks unto God. You know, sometimes we don't even thank him, God, for our hearing. We don't thank him for our toes. And we, when we don't have our toes to thank him, then we begin to say, Lord, what happened? So in everything, we must learn to give thanks. And I want to start out in the book of Philippians this morning as we, or this evening, as we talk about stigma. We kind of talked about it in our first session, but in Philippians chapter 4, I just want to read a couple of passages. As Pastor Mustafa was talking, he was talking about our mind, that we serve the Lord with our mind. And so when we look at Philippians chapter 4, verses number 8, it says, finally, brethren and sisters, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, to think on these things. And so my question today for us, when we deal with the internal stigma, we have to look at our thoughts and think about our thoughts, because our thoughts cause us to feel different ways. And when we are thinking, it causes us to behave different ways. And it depends on whatever situation we find ourselves in. And so when we talk about stigmas on today, those stigmas really deal with, again, our thoughts, our feelings, and our behavior. Because when we think certain things, we act out. Sometimes when people cuss you out, your thought process may be to cuss them out, right? And so when we think about the internal stigmas, one of the things that the scripture talks about and teaches us is that we must learn to control our members. In other words, we understand from scripture in James, it talks about that the tongue is unruly, right? It say, oh, we can control everything else. We can control a ship. We can control a big airplane in the air. We can control the cars that we drive. But our tongue, it talks about, is unruly, right? It's uncontrollable. There are some things that we say out of our mouths because we can't control our tongue that can be offensive to others and cause them to feel particular ways. And so when we think about the stigma and the stereotypes, I want to first thank you for all being here on tonight, because you don't have to be here, but praise God for your leader on tonight. Give your leader a hand praise, the angel of this house. I praise God for Pastor Mustafa because he keeps it real. He's not afraid and ashamed to tell what he's been through in his life, where God has brought him from. And so when we think about, again, our thoughts, our feelings, and our behavior, and each of us have our own personal testimony and personal story, but when situations occur, our thoughts about them and how we feel about those situations cause us to have emotional effects. And it causes us at times to act out on those emotional effects. We wonder why a lot of killing is taking place in our community, and it has to do with the spirit of anger. And because we don't work to tame that spirit of anger, because anger also has a spirit underneath that comes that causes the anger. And there's sometimes in our life things that have been said to us cause us to feel particular ways, and then we act out on those way that we're feeling. So for example, if I'm with this sister right here and I see another sister walking by, and her and I begin to talk about that sister, and that sister hears us talking about her, and then that sister may begin to believe what we have said about her. And so because she begins to believe, those internal thoughts can cause her to act one way or another. You know, have anyone in here ever been told that you ain't gonna be no good, or you ain't gonna be nobody, you're gonna end up in jail? So those things, you're gonna be dead by 18. People say all kind of things to us, right? One thing that we know, once it comes out, we can't take it back in. You might apologize to that person. You might tell them sorry, but guess what? The damage is already done because it's already out there. It's already out there.
If you're calling somebody lazy and they ain't doing nothing, guess what? They have that. It's in their ear process. Then if they begin to think about that, am I lazy? Am I lazy? And they begin to rehearse that. And then if that is true in their lives, they begin to believe that very thing about themselves. And then as they believe those very things, they begin to act on those things. And so what we want to do is, one, learn how to tame our tongue. As we are dealing with others, begin to learn to denounce the very things that they have said against us. See, because there are times when people say things against us, but scripture tells us what we just read, that we are supposed to think on the things that are lovely, that are true, that are of an honest report. And the negative things that are being said, we have to learn how to discount them. We have to learn how to rebuke them. Not today, devil, not today. I'm fearfully and I'm wonderfully made. I'm a peculiar person. He who begun the good work in me, he's faithful, able, capable of completing this work. I am the head and not the tail. I shall be successful no matter what the devil says. We have to learn how to turn the negative, which causes mental challenges in our people. We have to learn how to turn that around. So when we think about a cycle, we want to build on the cycle that our behavior, our thoughts, our feelings all come from different situations that we encounter. And so our goal today is to look at the cognitive behavior cycle that link thoughts, feelings, and behaviors. Now, if my brother is being successful out there, and I begin to say, and I become jealous of what he's doing and begin to talk about him in that, and then he hears me talking about him, maybe he might start doubting himself. That's why the scripture tells us that life and death is in the power of the tongue. And so our job as believers is to speak life to one another. The reason why many of the people that we see facing mental challenges that they're facing is because many of us have talked about them. Many of us have not encouraged them to do better, but we encourage them to do worse because of the words that we have said concerning them. And so when we talk about a cycle, it goes in a cycle. Somebody says something, you begin to think about it, you begin to process what you feel about what they said, and then you begin to act on it. And so our job is to be able to learn how to be slow to speak and to be able to learn not to jump to the offense so fast and to be able to learn not to take action so fast. Because usually sometimes when people are saying something we don't like, before we can even think about it, we've already said a rebuttal back to them. And so we must learn how to be slow to speak. When we think about mental illness becomes internalized. Individuals may be more likely to believe they are less worthy, they are less worth, they have less worth, and they're incapable of doing things because our society has set it up that way. Many people who are facing mental challenges, if they get the proper love, if they get the proper assistance that they need, if they get the proper help that they need from those who are peer support people, they can overcome that mental health challenge that they face. So we have to learn that the powerful strategy that can help us to interrupt the cycle of negativeness is one for us as believers to learn what the Word of God says about us. Many times, people don't know what the Word of God says about them, so they believe everything that the world says about them. And so the devil is a lie. He's been a lie from the beginning. He's still a lie today. And so until we as believers begin to believe the report of the Lord, we will continue to see those suffering from mental challenges. When we look at internal stigma, we look at it and we say, wow, now that guy's over there, we see him walking or something and carrying a blanket or something, and we begin to talk about how crazy he is. One of the things that we have to learn is to change our tongue, change how and what we say. Because even though they don't hear us, oh, you so crazy, they don't hear that, we're still putting it out in the atmosphere. We have to be careful what we're putting in the atmosphere. When we look at it, people are walking around. And instead of we're saying that they're crazy, we ought to be saying, Jesus, help, bless them, heal them, deliver them, God strengthen them, God save them. But many times we focus on the negative that society has said instead of the positive. Now, we have a whole bunch of people all around Oakland that's living in their cars, that's living in their campers, that's living on the streets. And many times people say, oh, they just there because they're crazy, they just want to be. And we don't know their condition. And one of the things that we have to say is, by the grace of God, it's not I. Because we don't know what our condition, what our plight, what our circumstance is going to be 5 months from now. Because some people are not even saving enough money to pay their rent for 1 month, right? So when that month comes over, if they say they don't have a job anymore, they don't have the finances, right? And so we look sometime at the people that are homeless and we associate them to having mental challenges. And yes, some do have mental challenges. And yes, I believe that some, the devil is really operating in. But there, God has showed us throughout his word that even those in the word of God that have went through things, and even this season, we can talk about Judas for a minute. Judas sold Jesus. We know that. We learned that through the scriptures. He betrayed him. But in the end, Judas committed suicide. Don't you know that that thing, internal stigma, bothered him so very much that he could no longer look himself in the mirror. He could no longer face himself, so he committed suicide. And so what am I saying on today? Sometimes there are things in us, Pastor Mustafa, that affect us so very much, where some of us say we feel like giving up and throwing in the towel. But I want to encourage you today. I want to encourage you that the lie they might have said about you that you might have internalized is a lie from the pit of hell. Because God created you for a purpose. And can nobody fulfill that purpose that he created you for? God has given you gifts. He's given you talents. He's given you assignments. And no one can fulfill that assignment but you. That's why we look in the body of Christ. We look in the book of Ephesians, and it says that the body has many members. It has many members, and it goes on to talk about that you can't tell the eye that you have no need of it. You can't tell the foot, because every single part, every single person in this place has a specific position God has placed you in, and no one can fill that position but you. The lie that they might have said, the things that they might have talked about, oh, you don't know what you're doing. Why God put her in that place or him in that position? Oh, you shouldn't be there. Keep doing what God told you to do. Don't allow no devil. Don't allow nobody to move. The wrong church. Go to another church. You doing the wrong thing. You try this. You should be preaching, or you should be teaching, or you should be. I want you to know today the internal and external stigmas that we hear and we face. Yes, it is a fight. It is a fight. You have to fight to not hear that. You have to fight. You know what? I'm going to make it, even if you said I'm not going to make it. I am going to graduate, even if you said I'm not going to graduate. I am going to walk in wholeness, even if you said I'm not going to walk in wholeness. You have to fight the internal and the external. Anyone face some external words? Anyone want to share? She shared how, and you shared how, the enemy was talking to her, right? And she also shared a key, how she had God and was able to have her communion with God, have that prayer time with God, and get delivered from that, feeling that guilt, right? But think about now the people that don't know God, that they don't have a higher power to go to. When they're feeling in the same way or a similar situation, right? The external and internal stigmas, we must fight daily. We have to fight daily. We cannot give up from fighting those external and internal.
See him come out, and then still it was a battle, because he went through a mental ordeal when he came out, and I was still trying to I was still grieving because my dad had passed, so it was a lot going on, and when I finally did go for still won't come to come back. So I fought my way here because it was like I was going through so bad. And it was on the place that the one that was here. And I didn't know where I was going, but the one that went to the church was going. What I heard, he told me the devil is alive. He prayed for me. And he gave me that sheet that had all the healing scriptures on it. And I read that every day. I wrote it down for 3x5 cards every time I would feel pain in my life. Or I feel that fatigue because it's hard to be so weak you can't get out of bed. But I would remember certain scriptures and I would say, because really, at that low point, the enemy wants you to believe that you finna lose it all. You finna leave up out of here. And I said, no. Because what God showed me I'm going to do, I got to do while I'm here. And I keep telling myself that to this day.
Praise God. The trick of the enemy trying to, it says, whose report will you believe? Whose report will you believe? I will believe the report of the Lord. The enemy will trick you up. John 10:10 says, Satan comes to steal, kill, and destroy. For three things. To steal your mind. Steal everything that you believe about yourself. Because once he is able to take over your mind, you don't care about nothing else. Then he's going to, he steals, and then he's going to kill. And then he's going to destroy, kill everything about you, any character you may have had about yourself. He's going to kill that, right? Because he wants you to believe whatever lie you may have been told. He wants you to believe that. And we have to fight the internalized stigmas that are negative, that we think over about ourselves. Because there are some things internally that's negative that we think about ourselves. I remember when I first had the bout with Bell's palsy and my face was much more twisted. I was like, God, you told me that. You called me to preach. You called me to be a minister. I'm not going to get in front of these people with my face like this. I'm not going to do it no more. So, and the enemy was trying to trick me out of Pastor Mustafa, getting in front of people, sharing the gospel of Christ, knowing what God had called me to do. And if I would have just allowed myself, okay, to listen, to follow what the enemy was saying, I would not even be right here before you today. So we have to look internally. Whatever they said about you is a lie. God created you, sister, for a specific purpose. And yes, we will face some things in our life. I understand the spirit of guilt. I understand that spirit. Because when I told my son to go and take Bart to San Francisco and he didn't come home, the enemy tried to say, it's your fault. If you would have let him drive, maybe that wouldn't have happened. That's the first thing I started thinking, right? Oh, the enemy was like, it's your fault. The devil is a lie. God has a plan for our lives. And we have to pray that as we go throughout this life, everything that we do it is pleasing unto God. And so I want us to really look this week, think about the internal stigmas that you are dealing with personally. Write them out on a piece of paper, and I want you to look at them. And each one, write by it, the devil is a lie. Find a scripture. Find a scripture to offset those
very things. When that enemy tells you you're sick and you're not going to be well, devil, you a lie, because God said I'm fearfully and I'm wonderfully made. God said that he is a healer. God said that beloved above all, I shall prosper and be in good health. I'm in good health, so devil, I'm not sick. You a lie. We have to talk to ourselves internally, and when the enemy is working externally, devil, you a lie. No matter what you say about me, I know who I am and whose I belong to. That's the position that we have to take. I believe as Peter says that we are a royal priesthood. We are a holy nation. We are a peculiar people. And if we're peculiar and if we're a holy nation and we know God is holy, guess what? God has all power. So what the lie that they said about us doesn't even matter, because God is greater than that lie. Again, I want you to really look at the internal stigmas that you're saying about yourself. We sometimes say all kinds of things about ourselves, worse than the external. And God wants us to know that He has created us. And not only has He created us, but He's created us for a purpose. And so the internal stigmas that we face, that we say about ourselves, if we can do something about those internal stigmas, then we got to do it. We got to ask God to give us the strength to do it. Because you know, the enemy, the world will have you looking at yourself. I don't like myself because I'm not the 36, 24, 36. I don't like myself because my feet are too big, or my hands are too big, or I don't have nails on, or my hair ain't growing. We have some internal stigmas. I almost want to say more than men as women, but that may not be true, because men have a lot of internal stigmas as well that they deal with, you know. And so when we look at these internal stigmas that we have, and then when we not only listen to them, we sometimes act out on those stigmas. And we have to begin to reverse that and flip that and change that. And the only way that we change that, one of the ways, well, there's a few ways. One of the ways, like the sister shared, she came to Pastor Mustafa. We need each other to encourage each other, to support each other, to share with each other. We need each other. We need each other. Not to gossip, not to down, not to talk about, not to discourage, but to encourage each other. Sister, no matter what they say, you're going to make. You're going to be that leader that you're aspiring to be. There's nothing that can stop you. You do your part and let God do the rest. Your part, whatever that is, in what you God has called you to do. Because even though He has given us the gifts and talents, we still have to do something with the gifts and talents that He has given unto us. Example, if you're a pastor or a preacher, you got to study the word. You got to study the word. I mean, you can't get, if you're going to preach in front of people, you got to study the word. So there's something God gifted you in that area, but the Bible says to study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that needed not be ashamed, but rightly dividing the word of truth. So you still have to study. If you're going to be a singer and you love singing, then my goodness, go home, practice in the mirror. Get your tape recorder out, singing to yourself, making melody and hymns, songs unto yourself. You're practicing. And maybe they said you wasn't going to be a singer. Well, devil, you a lie. I love to sing. God, help me. Help me sing, God. I'm going to sing. And keep singing. Because the more you sing, The more on key, the more better you'll get at singing. Same thing, if you at work and you want to be the manager, the more you do, show up on time, study the company, watch the manager, take the good that the manager's doing and implement it in your life, discard the negative, and then guess what? One day you'll process that we go through. But because of the internal and the external stigmas that we place on ourselves and the external stigmas that we hear, we don't believe that we have the ability to do the things that we desire to do because of the naysayers. I tease my grandson every time I talk to him in the morning, in the afternoon. I say, hey, King, good morning. Hey, Queen, right? Because he's a leader. He may not see it, or maybe he sees it. But I'm calling it as it is for him. We got to call those things that are not as though they are. They may not believe that they're going to get off drugs. God, I thank you that you're delivering them from drugs. Every prayer request, God, I thank you, God, that you're drawing them from the drugs, that you're taking the taste from their mouth. God, you're taking the taste from their hands. Their hands are not even going to want to touch it. God, we got to begin to speak against the things that have been spoken over our lives, our families' lives, and generations to come lives. Stigma. We're talking about the stereotypes and the stigmas that we face. Our thoughts. We have to tell ourselves, this example says to tell ourselves that we're doing fine. Tell ourselves that we could do this. We could do this. I can make it. I'm an overcomer. I can do this. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. We can do this thing. God, you said that if I ask, that you shall give. I'm trusting in you, God, that I'm going to be delivered from this situation. Whatever they said about me, God, they said I wasn't going to graduate. They said I wasn't going to make it. They said I wasn't going to be nobody. But God, you said the opposite. You said the opposite about me. We have to change our internal thinking. I cannot say that enough. We have to use positive examples to help explain our connections between our thoughts, feelings, and actions. The reason why some people are homeless is because people have told them all their life they wasn't going to be nobody and they was going to be where they are today. And we have to turn that around. You know, as I see you're out witnessing, you'll come up against a lot of people that will be there. Some may not smell so good, but that's not your job to say, oh, you stink. Oh, my God. You know, get away from me. No. It's your job to continue. Come on back, brother or sister. Come on back. They may smell to you, but still the process is the Lord will do the drawing. And the Lord will do the change. Because we can't even change hardly ourselves from thinking negative about ourselves. And so how are we going to change somebody else? We have to allow the love of God that manifests itself in our hearts to be outside of us, that people will see and know that they are loved by somebody. And that they will be encouraged by the people that love them. Two, our behavior. We have to be more willing to display external. In other words, we have to be willing as we're in the streets witnessing the people, to show the love of God to those people. The same way someone showed us the love of God, we have to be willing to show that love of God to others. And I didn't want to let you were sharing, and you didn't get to finish sharing your stigmas that you face. You want to share them?
Started from when I was young. In my youth, I was very small. I was skinny, becoming skinny. And then I wore these big old, thick glasses. So I always thought I didn't look very nice. And I was scared of people. I would hide. And and that led me to hiding medication and drugs, okay? But I didn't feel very good about myself. I never saw myself as looking good. I always saw myself as this person that wasn't very, my self-esteem was low, very low. And I medicated myself, and I started real, real young. I was only 5 years old.
It's real. Is praise God that at 5 years old, how she felt and started feeling concerning herself. She didn't say it was an external, but she said it was something in. And that's the same thing that happens to many of us. If we look back over our lives, there are things in our lives that cause us to feel particular ways about ourselves. And we have to change those particular ways. And again, as I said earlier, the very things that we could do something about, we can do it. Then do it. Those things that you can't, God, help me to love who you created me to be. Help me to be the woman or man that you called me to be. I feel this way. I don't like myself. Because when you're talking to God, we have to learn to be honest. God knows our hearts already, Pastor Mustafa. He already knows. He's just waiting some time for you to just speak up and say something. So the internal struggles, God, I'm facing low self-esteem. I don't know why I'm facing it, but please help me in this area and show me how to come out of this thing so that I'm not insecure, but that I'm secure. God, help me. I don't feel good about myself. I feel like I'm not beautiful, but I know you said that I'm beautiful, but show me, God, how to love myself and how to wake up and say to myself every day, Wanda, you're beautiful. You look good, girl. Keep on stepping. We got to talk to ourselves the opposite of what the enemy is planted in the earth. And when we do that, we will see things in us, those internal stigmas. We won't even be bothered with them anymore because they'll be leaving. And then you'll see another internal stigma that you might have been facing, and you begin to pray about that. And God will move that as well. But it requires us to do the work. It requires us to really be honest with ourselves and